So this was proposed, I guess, a while ago. It was a law. Now it's a regulation, and it's set to go into effect next month. Explain to us what's going on here.
You're right. It was proposed a very long time ago. It's been this just huge period of uncertainty where no one really knew exactly how this was going to pan out. And there was some argument that actually it was in the US government's interest to have a long period of uncertainty because it kept some of those deals away from the table, which they wanted to keep away from the table, notably Chinese investment into anything in sort of critical infrastructure technology in the US. They did need to now come to the fore and say, look, these are the new rules, which is what they've done. We have a good idea now of how it's going to look. There are still a couple of tweaks they're going to make, mm-hmm. but the key things here have been put into place. And obviously, like all things with M&A, certainty is the real driver of activity, and I'm sure we will see deals come to the fore.
Are we seeing this in effect already, or will it take some time to get it up and going?
Well, it comes into effect, as Romain said, next month. I think there are probably a lot of transactions.
But in spirit.
In spirit, it will, I think, move quite quickly because there will be deals that will have been being kind of looked at on the basis of, like, well, these are the various outcomes. Mm-hmm. We now have a clear direction of what is going to happen. So the deals that can now happen, I think, will go forward. That said, there will also be deals that people would have hoped they could have done, and I suspect we'll now say, you know, we're going to have to put this on the back burner indefinitely because it's just, there's no receptivity here. Right?
So this is ostensibly being done under the umbrella of national security, protecting national security. It's going through a Cfius. We talk about Cfius a lot. We've seen a couple of deals over the last couple of years sort of get tripped up through that Cfius process, or at least the threat of it. Are you hearing from folks that you talk to in the M&A world that they're concerned that this could actually curtail, I guess, the amount of M&A, or at least maybe the number of potential investors?
Well, it definitely has already. It's had a very, very chilling effect on inbound M&A into the US, mm-hmm. Particularly from China. We actually saw this huge run-up in Chinese M&A sort of going, you know, really from the beginning of this cycle up until about 2 years ago. And then since then, there's just been this sudden fall-off because anything coming in from mainland China is seen as potentially having government influence and therefore is subject to pretty stringent review. Now, what's interesting in the news today is that they have given the first indication of the exemptions that they'll put on certain countries. So Australia, the UK and Canada are the only countries currently exempt. Interestingly, New Zealand, the only other member of the Five Eyes, is not exempt. And I actually was surprised. I thought the pound would rally a bit more on this because it shows that America does see the UK as having material differences from the rest of Europe as a trading partner and as someone who has sort of similar expectations.
So do we think that if there's a foreign buyer out there, a Chinese company, that they might try to go through a UK company or any of the exempted countries as a way to get in?
Very difficult for them to do that. So one of the things that was made clear today was, look, if you're private equity and you have an offshore vehicle and you're buying through that, that's fine as long as your principal business is in the US. So, for instance, if you're Blackstone, you're buying through a Cayman Island listed company, that's okay because you're still a US company. What they will look very carefully at is if the activity, the primary activity of the investment firm is in a country they don't like the look of, it doesn't really matter whether they're buying through a vehicle in America or not. They will just look at where the influence lies.
Do we have any idea if there is going to be some sort of retaliatory aspect to this where a US firm looking to invest in China or wherever else might be blocked?
Yeah, it's a great question. The answer is yes, and we've already seen that. We saw it, if you remember, and Scarlett and I remember covered this quite closely last year, we had the NXP Qualcomm debacle where MOFCOM, which has now also changed its name to Samra to make things confusing, they blocked that deal on sort of pretty spurious grounds, and it was seen as a very direct retaliation for the US blocking. If you remember when they said that Broadcom could not acquire Qualcomm because it was potential influence from the Chinese.
Cfius, MOFCOM, Senra, just alphabet.
Firma, right. I know. Initialisms and acronyms all over the place.